It's 16 degrees outside this January morning with a wind chill near zero. But Chad Campbell of Rochester Hills is on the bike putting in road miles. The start of racing season is still 3 months away, but because of Chad's commitment to racing, he finds the discipline to train throughout the winter on days like today. He has to, because his competition is most probably doing the same thing. Years old, no college, living at home, and slinging pizzas for minimum wage, Chad has put off real life in order to pursue the goal of becoming a pro bike racer. College will always be there. Youth, however, will not. He's been blessed with supportive family and friends, so he's seizing the opportunity to follow unconventional paths. That alone is worthy of admiration. Some say that cycling is the most physically demanding sport, and who could argue? Spending 3 hours at top speed just inches from the rider next to you is both a physical and mental drain. But what's more draining to the athlete is the expense of the sport, expense in time and money. In order to compete at Chad's level, one must obviously have the best of equipment, but also the time to train. Because the USCF, the United States Cycling Federation, allows amateurs to receive prize money, competition is intense at this level. So intense, in fact, that little distinction is made between the pro teams and amateur teams. Teams like Coors Light and the Saturn Cycling Team, which pamper their riders with a fleet of vehicles, a staff which includes mechanics to look after the bikes, and soigneurs who tend to the riders' every need, even if it's just a bottle of water. While the pro teams will fly first class to each race, Chad and his Kinetic Systems racing team will drive throughout the Midwest to get to a race 8 hours away in a car loaded down with equipment. This is every weekend from April to October. Social life is a contradiction in terms to a cyclist. Their only interest is in racing their bikes, even if there's only a slight chance of winning. It's part of the addiction. Winning isn't the point. There's something about the speed and the color that has these riders hooked, the subtle intricacies of riding at 100% in a pack of riders working out strategies in what is often called a rolling chess game. It must be a strong hook to bring them to the same starting line as the top guns of U.S. cycling, like Coors Light rider Davis Finney, who has earned the nickname the Cash Register. Or Saturn's Dave McCook, a national champion who at one point in time was riding for a small team similar to Chad's. Now he's at the top. That is a ray of hope for Chad and his Kinetic Systems team, knowing that it's not impossible and that hard work pays off in the end, to know that they won't always and don't always watch the pack leave them behind. The Kinetic Systems team enjoyed many times this year the spotlight of being the Midwest's top cycling team. At events such as the Harbor Springs Cycling Classic, which is small enough not to attract the large pro teams, yet is big enough to draw large crowds and pay good prize money, the Kinetics team, to put it simply, dominated the weekend. On Saturday, the Kinetic Systems racing team placed four riders in a seven-man breakaway. Their odds of winning the race were great. Out of this breakaway came Pete Navarre and Bjorn Carlson, a U.S. national team candidate from Minnesota. After 80 miles of racing, the two riders jockeyed for position in a game of cat and mouse preparing for the sprint as the referee watched for violations. Finally, with the finish line less than 200 meters away, Navarre attacked, held off a late charge by Carlson, and threw his hands up to celebrate the victory. On Sunday, the short course Criterium in downtown Harbor Springs saw another breakaway, heavily weighted with three Kinetic Systems team riders, while the remaining teammates controlled the pace of the chasing main field. With three laps to go, Navarre again left the breakaway behind and soloed to his second win of the weekend. It was a team victory, for not only did they help to secure Peter's solo effort, they also finished the race with four Kinetic Systems riders in the top six places. It was a great weekend for the Kinetics team, as earlier in the day, Mark Millward also soloed away from his chasers to win the junior category event.
So up until Thursday night when my dad called me, it looked like I was going to be working like 60 hours a week to pay for rent.
Throughout the winter months, the team met at a Rochester restaurant to plan the upcoming season. It was also a time to discuss doubts.
I'm just tired of being poor. Pretty much. Everything seems like every time I start to get a little bit of a savings or something else happens. This winter has been really hard because I've been really battling with it because I've had all these bills and a lot of my friends are graduating and they're getting jobs and they're doing all this cool. They're like, come on, man, do it. Come on, let's go. We're gonna go up north skiing for the whole weekend and it's only gonna be like $150.
Stevie's worries, too, are common among cyclists and, in fact, among many athletes. There are always temptations to put aside aspirations of an athletic career and follow conventional paths. The decision is made even more difficult when you've already proven that you can compete, that you have what it takes physically to have an impact on the sport. You've come as far as you can, alone. Now, what'll it take to get you to the next level? What's the hook? What's the allure to such an expensive and demanding sport? What's the attraction to a sport in which the rewards don't always outweigh the cost? Many-time national champion and former Olympic team member John Howard once wrote, "My infatuation with cycling, I now realize, goes much deeper than racing or even winning. The sport has substance, the legends, international flair, jargon, seasonal unions, lasting friendships, the unseen strategies, and the never-ending thrill of adventure. These are the diamonds of my youth." Very few moments in life can replace the feeling of putting your hands in the air to celebrate a victory, or the completely spent feeling of gutting out a long road race. The satisfaction of seeing your teammate interviewed as the winner, or going toe-to-toe with the top guns. It's all there in one single sport, the sport of cycling. We've been led to believe in America that hitting 50 home runs is the ultimate achievement in sports, or that the Super Bowl is the highest level of accomplishment. Well, money isn't everything. There are still some exciting sports in America in which the athletes are involved for the true love of the sport, the excitement, the challenge, the thrills. There are no million-dollar contracts in American cycling. In fact, it's often a break-even proposition. Riders will willingly sleep in their cars and survive on bagels and bananas in order to save money and race. Even teams such as Chad Campbell's Kinetic Systems Racing Team. If life's rewards are measured in dollars and cents, then they're not going to get rich. If fulfilling dreams is the guide, then these are the most successful people you'll ever meet.